Dog right there?
I have no idea. I feel like I can see shit. Stop it. Susie, sit down. Yeah, they're just dogs wandering around.
Under elevation gain. Wow, that's higher than I thought. Did you think that was a 1400?
I have no idea.
Oh, climbing Baldy is 3000. She's back there on the floor.
All right, girls, we're heading home. Some bone snooze time. Yeah, so why were these parked over here? Jesus.
The personnel they need and the medical personnel they have.
Well, my colleagues on the border last week, including Dr. Goza, who we just heard, shared that in the facilities they went to, they saw not a single pediatrician. And we, as the American Academy of Pediatrics, are asking for urgent presence of pediatric expertise at every step of the border. We know that our law enforcement agents are there to protect our border, and we, as pediatricians, are there to protect the health and well-being of children.
We've had a lot of reports this week about bad behavior by in and around those facilities, but let's just for a moment assume those people doing their very best. What don't they know that we need to know in order to be able to properly care for these situations?
Well, children are not real adults. They express illness differently than adults do. This means their vital signs may be different, so they can breathe more quickly. It may be harder to detect the subtle signs of illness under a t-shirt. Children can get sick more quickly than adults. They require more fluid for their weight. We even dose medications differently based on the weight of a child as an adult in a standard dose. So we as pediatricians have expertise in detecting differences between a child who's well, a child who has a minor illness, and a child who has a serious illness. If we don't urgently change the process that we have at the border with pediatric expertise, I can anticipate that we'll be the worst.
Thank you very much for doing this. I'm going to go back to the reason that some of the institutions have to have people in the terminal, so the more that you ask them next. The collective carries this account from one pediatrician's experience with the children in federal custody in Dallas, Texas. Inside the border patrol warehouse, one person had a mother.
Remember Isaac's statement, the business department of my employer? Well, one thing has another problem. Now, deep in the world, which is it's called business awareness. Sneakers.